an example of where this would occur. Worldwide use of the internet is increasing at an exponential rate, with traffic doubling every 100 days. What is the exponential growth rate? So if we want to find K, we can divide natural log 2 by the doubling time, which in this case is 100 days. Natural log 2 divided by 100. Now we do have to close the parentheses here, divided by 100. It's approximately 0.0069. Which as a percentage would give us approximately 0.69%. What's quite amazing about this is it's per day. So it's approaching 1% increase per day, which is quite dramatic. Let's take a look at one more example. The world population was approximately 6.04 billion at the beginning of 2000. It has been estimated that the population is growing exponentially at the rate of 0.016 or 1.6% per year. Well, if this is the case, then we know that the derivative of p with respect to t would be 0.016 times the function p. Find the function that satisfies the equation. Okay, let's recall our basic function. P of t is equal to p naught e to the power of kt. Okay, so for this situation, P of t is equal to the initial population referring to the year 2000, e to the power of 0.016 times t. Now it is important to note that t equals 0, our base year, represents the year 2000. Estimate the world population at the beginning of 2020. Again, since our base year was the year 2000, we use the value t equal to 20. So p of 20 is equal to 6.04 times e raised to the power of 0.016 times 20. To save some time, I've already calculated this value, and it comes out to approximately 8.32 billion people. Okay, and the last question. After what period of time will the population double that in the year 2000? So remember the shortcut. To find the doubling time, we can simply take natural log 2 and divide by k. So in this problem, natural log 2 divided by our growth rate, and that will come out to approximately 43.32 years. So according to this model, the population will double that of the year 2000 in a little over 43 years. I hope that helps explain the relationship between exponential functions and calculus, as well as how to solve some basic exponential growth problems. Thank you and have a good day.